to get smaller when bigger waiting on you.
Yes.
I ain't got no talk to you. Why are you in this small little box when God wants you to step outside the box? Anybody ready to step outside the box? I call your name and say name. Why are you still in the box? Somebody, it's time for bigger. Yes, can I tell you something? Say to God, do not allow others to limit your living.
Amen.
Tell you, you can't have it. You should have it. Come here, Jabez. Talk to me for a minute. Jabez called on the God of Israel. He said, and Lord, my coat. Hallelujah. And Jabez didn't let his name change his living. I come to let somebody know, I don't care if you're growing up in a project, you ain't got to stay in a project. Dictate your living because I'm going to call on the name of Jesus because his name is above every name. They call me a dropout, but his name is above every name. They call me a homer, but his name is above every name. They call me a drunk, but his name is above every name. You can think big in small places.
Yes, you can.
No, you thinking if you in a small place, you got to think small.
No.
I can be, for instance, I can be in a one bedroom apartment, but I'm thinking about living in a 3-4-5 bedroom house. My Benz and my Lexus and my Cadillac. Because the Bible that I read says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he.
Yes.
You know how they told us, Apostle, you are what you eat. I got another one for you. You are what you think. Y'all better catch the revelation. What you thinking about yourself?
Yes.
You want other people to think for you. No. As a man thinking in his heart. I can't think in my heart what I want you to have. You got to think in your own heart what you want to have.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I got to start thinking about what I want God to do. Abundantly above all you ask, unthink. God said, whatever thought you have, guess what he said? I'm a supersede that. You're asking for a new job. God said, if you think big enough, I'll allow you to open your own business. Anybody want to be an entrepreneur? And death is in the power of the tongue.
Amen.
And they that never eat the fruit thereof. Why are you mad about something you fixed and served? I can remember grandmama fixing the food in the kitchen and she would taste it. And she often sometimes say, it don't taste right. And how is it that you the cook and you ain't gonna eat your own food? Y'all eat what you done said out your mouth. out your mouth.
Oh, come on. I got.
Y'all are young.
Oh,
I got a question for everybody in the house.
Come on,
we about to go. Uh-huh. Is there anybody in here tired of an undersized status?
Woo! Yes.
What's an undersized status? An undersized status is, I never have enough to do what I want to do. Anybody tired of being undersized? Anybody tired of, don't have enough to do what you want to do? Is there anybody tired of mid-sized status? What's a mid-sized status? Mid-sized is just having enough to do what you need to do. Hallelujah. But I got a question for you, saints of God. Is anybody here ready for the oversized status? My assignment is to activate you for bigger on tonight.
Yeah, all right.
He sent me, in other words, he sent me to set things in motion for bigger to pursue you.
Yeah.
And guess what? He set now your bigger in motion to pursue you. It's time for you to get up and go after your bigger. You and your bigger gonna be halfway. Have triggered every possibility to open up for you.
Yes.
That's why the enemy is fighting you so hard.
Come on now.
Can I tell you something?
Yes.
Apostle Bruce, most of us think that the enemy is fighting us because of the promise that God spoke over our life. He's not fighting because of the promise that was spoken. He's fighting you because of the possibility that one day you might realize you are God. And God he or she might wake up and realize what I have for them, and they go out there with all their heart. I want to cut them off before they get. I got to cut them off before they get the revelation of who they are.
Yes.
Come on.
In other words, thanks to God, you about to discover.
Yes, sir.
Bigger is about to discover you.
Yes, sir.
Ooh,
yes,
God, sir. I'm dying. Hallelujah. How can we not be great when the greater one live on the inside of us? If the greater one live on the side of, inside of us, greater got to come to us. Anybody ready for greater? Anybody ready for bigger?
Yes, sir.
Bigger all around me. Bigger all upon me. I'm just living in bigger.
Yes, sir.
Just living. Come on, sir.
Hey.
Yes, just living.
Saints of God, I don't know about you, I can't even speak for you.
Yes.
But tell your neighbor, I am approved for bigger. Not only am I approved for bigger, I am aligned for bigger. I'm in alignment for God. Not only am I approved for bigger, not only am I in alignment for bigger, but I am assigned to bigger. I go right to the
doctor.
Apostle Bruce, you got all the barrels right. They mean they assigned to you. Everywhere you go, they follow you. That's what the biggest don't do to you. Or tonight, everywhere you go, yes. I don't care where you go, bigger gonna follow you. Bigger gonna discover you. Anybody ready for bigger? But when you, woman of God, when you approve for bigger, you align for bigger, guess what you gotta do? You gotta make an adjustment for the bigger.
Yes.
Is there anybody ready to make an adjustment for the bigger? Yes. is changing. Yeah, your status is changing. You're going from smaller to larger. You're going now from smaller to bigger. I come to let somebody know.